It is a good morning. Thank you very much, Mandisa. Guess who's back in town? Robin. Robin McLean back in town. Looking good. Looking like a New Yorker.
It was fun. I sure missed all of you guys a lot.
Let's just cancel all of our guests. All I want to do is talk to you about your trip to New York. Just cancel everybody. Call them all up. Say, don't worry about it. We're not doing it today. We're just going to chat with Robin. A week in New York. You must have at least a few hours of things to tell us.
Yeah.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you for tuning in. It is Wednesday. You made it to the middle of the week. Got a good guest lineup for you. And hopefully we will get to them. I'm just yanking your chain. Ronnie tried to yank Dan's chain yesterday, by the way.
Did he?
Did you hear that story?
No, I didn't.
Good morning, Robin. Good to have you
good
back.
Morning,
man,
Mary.
It is good to have you back. We missed you. In more ways than just on the show, by the way. In more ways than just here. I mean, you were missed in so many different ways. Yes. You know, Dan was coming in for you every day. And so it was very, very helpful for me to have somebody else to banter with a little bit. But it was not something he was used to. He's not used to getting up this early. Yesterday, Ronnie, and for those who don't know, Ronnie is Robin's husband, called me just before we went on the air. And he was watching Dan on the monitor here. And he told me to tell him that you were going to be up there another week. And so I don't know if Dan picked up on the fact that I was, you know, he was getting ready to be pranked, or if he just didn't believe me at all. But when I finally mentioned it,
yeah,
which is when you were on the phone,
yeah,
calling from wherever you were up there,
yeah.
I don't think he believed it at all. I don't think he fell for it at all. By the way, I got a special piece of music I loaded up just to have you, just to let you know. Wait, wrong piece of music. Here's a piece of music just to welcome you back. Are you ready? This is what it feels like right now. Are you ready? Hey, Robin is back in town. This is the music I used yesterday for our promo for today.
Oh, wow.
Because my favorite part is coming up. Are you ready for it? Here it is.
Okay.
Robin is back in town.
This is awesome.
We need confetti.
I've never been part of
we need jugglers.
You've
never been part of what?
Of a ticker tape parade before.
Yeah, it's got clowns in it here.
Yeah, I do.
By the way, that's what I sounded like busking last Friday night, just like that.
No, I bet you did great. You said you got a lot of funds for the Marion County
$33.
$33. Awesome.
It worked out to about $10 an hour.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, so we had some story. It wasn't as fun as when I do the busking with you, but yeah.
Yeah, but I bet you.
I think half the fun of busking is yucking it up with you. You know, mm-hmm. I was yucking it up with Doug a little bit, I guess.
Yeah.
But anyway, so how you doing?
I'm doing great. I'm doing great. Had a wonderful time.
Can't wait to hear. I know you've been calling in every morning, but it's mm-hmm. always fun to have you here. See, the phone is often difficult. It is. I don't like phones, really. I'm not a big phone guy.
No.
And I know we do phones for interviews, but you know, it's always better when they're in here.
Yeah.
No, I won't ask any New York questions right now. First, let me tell you who's coming on the show this morning.
Yeah.
Bring back the Bible at 7:30.
Okay.
You know, this whole week I haven't even been doing it this way.
Oh.
Because you prepared me with these one little sheets, these one sheet things.
Right.
Rather than this whole big book, so it was real nice and tidy.
Oh, nice.
Just put it right here. Well, you did it for me. they were all laid out. For those who don't know, let me just give you a little insight what this was like while Robin was gone. Before she left, she prepared every single day for me. Right?
Mm-hmm,
it was lined up in a row. And of course, me, I messed up the line. And so one day I had the wrong thing in here, and it was just a mess. All right, so let me make sure I have everything set here. All right, Pastor Walter B. Smith. First of all, let me put him to the right day. It's got the wrong day on it. All right. Pastor Walter B. Smith, first at 7:30, his program, Bring Back the Bible. Have not met the man yet.
No.
Well, they say he'll have to come in here. 7:35, we have left open so that we could chat a little bit. I'm looking forward to chatting with you about your New York trip. News Bites at 8:35 when we talk about the news. And had fun doing that with Dan, by the way.
Oh, cool.
Aaron D. Snyder is a diabetes survivor, a certified trainer, a nutritional consultant, and Aaron is coming out at 9:05. He's got a book called The New Diabetes Prescription, The Diet, Exercise, and Mindset Revolution. Tony Lowry is coming on at 9:35. He's the founder and president of the Youth Mentoring Connection. He's going to talk about keeping your child in school, the connection between literacy, illiteracy, and juvenile delinquency.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that one.
And then I know that if you're the wife of a famous person, you really want to be known in your own right. Mm-hmm. But this lady is the wife of somebody famous. His name is Herb Alpert.
Yeah.
He's not coming on, but she is. But she does have some career. Definitely. See, this is the bad part when you're married to somebody famous. You don't want to be overshadowed by that famous person. Lonnie Hall Alpert is famous in her own right. She actually won a Grammy as a singer.
Yeah.
She's a lyricist, songwriter, survivor of the Epstein-Barr virus, which is probably why she's coming on our show. She's written a book called Emotional Memoirs and Short Stories, an honest look at the life of Lonnie Hall Alpert.
Yeah, that is so cool.
Herb Alpert, Tijuana brass guy.
Yeah.
Legally Yours today at 10:35. That is the show hosted by John Fuller, attorney here in Ocala at the law firm of Fuller & Fuller. And then Linda Misle Wagner is coming on at 11:05. She's an inspirational speaker. Her book is called Get Me Out of This Fat Suit, Confessions of a True Fatty.
Yeah.
Anyway, so she'll be on. That's also, by the way, a diabetes type of a discussion. And I only guessed that because of the website.
Yeah.
Right, I'll tell you about that in a little bit.
She's an obesity survivor.
It's a new phrase.
I know.
I've heard that before.
I know. It's
an all right. So first question I have. We all have this question. You teased us. You said there was a naked woman photo you were going to send us.
Yep.
Saw nothing.
Nope.
What happened? Facebook took it down?
But no, it was it just wouldn't go there. Some of the photos I took, I tried to take photos every
day,
and then some of them got uploaded, and some of them didn't. Okay. So now tonight I'll be able to send you.
So there was a lady in Times Square totally undressed.
Yeah, she had body paint on, and she was just gorgeous. She was raising money for breast cancer, and she was just the cutest thing ever. She was just kind of dancing around in her high heels, and she was wonderful.
So she had shoes on.
Yeah, high heels and a thong.
So did you? There were a lot of people. Was there a lot of traffic? Let me ask you this: was there a lot of cars that were not yellow?
No, most of the cars were yellow. Yes, they were, and we rode a couple of cabs, and my mother was glad she sat in the back seat because it was like zooming in and out and stopping and.
Why did you sit in the front seat?
Yeah, well, there were four of us.
Oh, okay.
So we fit in the back, and the cabbie let me sit up front. So
oh wow, cool.
We could go places, so that was awesome. And
I don't think I ever sat in the front seat of a cab.
Well, and let's see on. On Sunday, my son drove into the city, so he was like a New York cab driver. I mean, he was zipping in and out and had his blinker on and stuff. It was a lot of fun.
His blinker on.
Yeah. But the horns are unbelievable. Let's see, Saturday there was a Korean Day parade, so they had all of the streets, you know.
Korean Day.
Yep.
Something new.
And Sunday there was a Columbus Day parade, so they had all the streets on Fifth Avenue. Uh-huh. Yeah, they were blocked off. So it's either Sunday or Monday now. I can't remember the Columbus Day parade, but it was amazing.
It's a city for parades.
High energy.
Big parade city.
Yeah.
Close down some roads and have a parade.
The police officer said there's usually one almost every Saturday because of all the ethnicities up there.
Yeah, well.
And they close down the roads on Fifth Avenue.
Should do that here.
It's so cool.
I'm sure we have just as much ethnicity here.
Yeah. Well, it's a lot of fun. Very high energy. The subways were great. The train was great from Jersey into the city. And there was a quiet car. We got into the quiet car one time.
What is a quiet car?
That's where nobody talks, nobody laughs, nobody does anything. Because that car is strictly for people if you want to sleep. or just
really,
you know, yeah, it's something called a quiet new car. So it was like, okay, TJ's starting to say, this is the, and then he goes, this is the quiet car.
The quiet car.
Yeah. So the first car on wow, the train from Jersey to New York is the quiet car. It's a double decker, and you know, you can sleep and nobody talks. It was just
so now, how long is strange the ride from where you got on the train to when you get off the train?
It was about 20 minutes.
I would sleep right past the stop. 20 minutes.
Yeah, and it was quiet, too. I mean, there was like, you couldn't even hear anybody breathing. So we didn't say a word. We're just looking around at these guys in suits. And
but here's the thing that I remember. I mean, this is years ago, but it's like every car had people sleeping in them. I don't remember it needing to be quiet.
Yeah, but this is a...
Was it quiet? I mean, did they do something so that you don't hear the whir of the wheels?
Right. It was really quiet. It's
they must have done some kind of technology, huh?
Yeah, the first car of the train, and then when we took the train back, we didn't go in the quiet car. We went in the, you know, the regular car.
Could you hear the wheels there?
Everybody, yeah, it was great.
You mean they did? Why don't they turn off the wheels in every car?
I don't know, but you know, and the seats in the quiet car was, you know, real Hollywood
cushy
seats.
Do you have to pay more for the quiet car?
No, nope. But you just gotta follow etiquette. It's the quiet car.
Well, I can't wait to hear more. Wow. Well, so we really missed you here. And
I sure missed you guys, too.
And of course,
Patsy, especially.
And you know, well, like I said, it wasn't just the show. We didn't miss you just on the show. We missed you everything you do. We had fun. Dan came in here, and it was fun doing it with Dan. And
yeah.
Had a different, I don't know, different feel, I guess you would say. Different, mm-hmm, whatever.
A different personality.
There's a word I'm thinking I can't think of.
Everybody has to be their own personality. You can't be somebody else. You guys did a good job. I enjoyed talking to you and Dan.
Let's go to Pastor Walter B. Smith, Bring Back the Bible, and then we'll come back to Robin. How about that?
Well, a good day to you, and welcome again this morning to Bring Back the Bible. The Bible says in Proverbs 30:33, surely the churning of milk bringeth forth butter, and the wringing of the nose bringeth forth blood. Well, in addition to being a skilled medical doctor, Walter Wilson was a fervent witness for Christ. He once encountered a very young man, a skeptic, who had been taught to believe that the Bible simply was not true. The young man challenged Dr. Wilson, claiming that the Christian faith rested on ancient fairy tales, to which Dr. Wilson replied, "If I show you a verse in Scripture that is true, will you listen to what I have to say?" And the young man agreed. Dr. Wilson then opened his Bible to that verse, Proverbs 30:33, where it says, "The wringing of the nose bringeth forth blood," and the skeptic agreed to listen to the gospel without insisting the truth of that scripture be demonstrated upon him. Well, there is great power in the Word of God because it came to us from God himself. Over and over, men have laughed at what the Bible says, only to be proven wrong in their doubting. And though our faith does not rest on archaeology, history, or science, folks, there are no contradictions between what God says and what is true. The problem with the Bible is not that it is outdated or errant, but that it is not believed and obeyed. Jesus answered Satan's temptation by saying, "It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God." Matthew 4 and verse number 4.
You've got a garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
ABC News Now. I'm Karen Chase. The government shutdown, now in its ninth day, is affecting military families who are no longer getting traditional veteran death benefits to help cover funeral costs and other final expenses. Government food inspectors, sidelined by the government shutdown, are being called back into action to investigate a salmonella outbreak involving chicken from a Central California farm. Nearly 300 people have been sickened in 18 states. Boston is bracing for a second day of a school bus driver's strike. Union drivers walked off the job yesterday, saying the city hasn't honored their contract. leaving in the lurch more than 30,000 students and parents. Reports of shots fired at Princeton University triggered a lockdown and a campus-wide electronic alert, but turned out to be unfounded. Princeton officials say no one was hurt, and the school is open today. New Jersey Governor Chris Christie isn't ruling out a run for the White House. During a debate with his gubernatorial opponent last night, Christie says right now he's focusing on his current job, but he'll be looking for another job in 2017. This is ABC News.
Life is a wild ride, but even that couldn't prepare you for this. You're on your ninth wild ride, the Carnival Twist and Whirl, your granddaughter's wishes trumping your amusement park fears. And it's here, healthy enough to feel the joy over the terror that the question hits you. How did I get here? Was it just hard work or smart choices? Like choosing Rite Aid and exclusive benefits for seniors with Rite Aid's new Wellness 65 Plus program. You get free pharmacist consultations that include medication reviews, blood pressure screenings, and immunization checklists. Wellness 65 Plus also gives you points for every prescription, even Medicare, that earn you up to 20% off your Rite Aid purchases fast. All meant to keep you here. Now that you've actually gotten here, here. Being the best and bravest grandma in the whole wide world. Stop by and enroll free in Wellness 65 Plus at Rite Aid today. With us, it's personal. Certain limitations apply. See your Rite Aid store or riteaid.com for details.
Hurricane season is upon us. WOCA and Sunbelt Rentals wants you to be prepared. Sunbelt Rentals has the equipment to help, like air nailer, aerial lifts, chainsaws, chippers, and stump grinders. They have light towers, skid steer loaders, and generators, just to name a few. Sometimes you might need a little help cleaning up afterwards. Sunbelt has the equipment you need, like dehumidifiers, pumps, sewer snakes, wet dry vacs, floor dryers, carpet equipment, and more. And right now is the time to get it done, with two special offers just for WOCA listeners. If you rent Friday after 3 p.m. and return it Monday before 9 a.m., you will only be charged for one day. Plus, just by mentioning WOCA, you get 25% off your rental. You heard right, not 5 or 10, but 25% off your rental just by mentioning that you heard it here on WOCA. But you'd better hurry. This is a limited time offer. Visit Sunbelt today on Highway 27, just half mile east of I-75. Give them a call at 369-9101 or visit them on the web, sunbelt.com.
Thank you very much, Dan. 25 minutes before 8 o'clock Wednesday morning. Hope you're doing well. I see it's overcast out there. I felt a little cooler this morning when I first got outside, and Rob and Mike Blaine back home.
Yeah.
Back in the studio, back from her trip to New York, and we've got the clowns here ready to play a little ka-ra-ra-boom-dee-ay. Here we go. So we purposely left this segment open so that we could kind of just banter a little bit and talk about your trip. So, all right, so let's get into the nitty gritty of it. Now, did you actually go on the double-decker bus every single day?
Yeah, we did. Thursday we went to the Jersey Shore and did that. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday we're on the double-decker bus. Once you buy your ticket, you can each loop takes about 2 hours, and then once you buy your ticket, you can go on and off and see different things, and you don't have to pay anything anymore. So we use that as transportation also, going to different places.
That is pretty cool. Now, how many people? I didn't know that. I mean, I never knew that you could get on that bus. Mm-hmm. Well, and what do you do? Just tell the guy, hey, I want to get off right here?
No, you get up there, and then if you have a specific stop in mind before he announces it, then you tell him what you want to see, and then he'll tell you when that stop is coming up. Otherwise, the bus stops at different places, and then he'll announce that.
And were you like in a sea of New York accents?
I didn't even know.
You couldn't even tell.
No, because
you said so mixed around here.
Yeah, there were people from Germany and Korea and China and France. And what was cool about
I got you, because on the bus it's a bunch of tourists.
Yeah, okay. And it was great because you got these mini headsets like you use for your iPod, and you plug it into the side of the bus. Well, the gentleman is speaking in English on channel one, then there are six more channels for six different languages.
Really?
So as he speaks, it's not recorded, pre-recorded. So, you know, you hear his little nuances and jokes and things. And so you've got six different languages that you can hear it in.
Wow.
It's pretty cool.
You mean this technology translating him?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
I wonder if there's anything that just doesn't really translate awesome. And it becomes offensive. Whoa, what did he say?
Yeah, can you imagine that?
So just help me understand. So there's a loop. Let's say, give me an example of a loop.
One is the downtown loop, and is that
the downtown loop? Down lower Manhattan, you mean?
Yeah, okay. that's what you would consider where the Empire State Building is and Rockefeller Center and stuff.
I guess so. That's probably the upper end of downtown
stuff. And then the uptown loop was like the Dakota and Central Park.
Okay.
And all the historic buildings.
Did you go to Harlem at all?
Yes, we did.
Okay, yep. That's what I would call uptown.
Yep.
Is Harlem.
Yep, we went to Harlem too.
Did you get off the bus there?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, we walked around. It was, you know, different. But we walked around, and then there was a night tour. The night tour, you don't get off the bus.
Right.
You stay on the bus for 2 hours, and you go over the top of the Manhattan Bridge, whatever that double bridge is. You go over the top, you go into Brooklyn, and you come back. So it's like a variety of all of the boroughs at nighttime.
Oh, cool. So did you go over the Brooklyn Bridge in the bus?
No. It was the Manhattan Bridge.
I don't know.
Whatever bridge it was. It wasn't the Brooklyn Bridge.
They got a new tunnel going in there, too. I was looking
at
something.
Oh, really? That's cool.
I guess under the East River. So
under the East River, that's a good place.
So when you got off the bus, you wait for another one to come around?
Yeah, once.
So then you're sitting with a bunch of new tourists.
You don't wait. You go out and you go see whatever it is you're going to see. And then when you feel you're done with that area, then you just go to that particular bus stop. And then you wait.
Just wait for another one.
Well, they run every 20 minutes. So
okay.
It's just so cool. So you have your little ticket stub and they just let you up the bus. And it was really wonderful.
So what kind of things did you get off the bus for?
We saw Rockefeller Center and Central Park, the Empire State Building. Went down and TJ, my son, he works 3 blocks from the Empire State Building. So he knew what general vicinity the stuff was that we wanted to see. But he's got this iPhone or smartphone, whatever it is, and he has a GPS system. So he plugs in where we are and where we want to go, and then it tells you what subway to ride. It tells you what direction to go if you're walking and stuff. Wow. So anyway, he's got this, there's this waffle cart there, and they make these wonderful waffles, and and you have to call this phone number to find out where the waffle cart is.
Oh, wow.
So it's different waffle batter, and it's got these different toppings on. So he found out where the waffle cart was. We walked over there. There's a hamburger place there that's around Central Park somewhere. And he said during the week the lines are like you stand in line to order these burgers, and the wait is like an hour to an hour and a half.
Oh my goodness!
But we only had to wait 30 minutes, so that was good for that. So that was pretty cool.
It's New York hype, right?
It was so neat. It was
the best hamburgers in the world, right here. Everybody believes it.
I know, they do. It was just
here's the thing about food with New York, and this is anybody who's a tourist. Probably anywhere. This doesn't just apply to New York. If that restaurant is in your town, don't go to it. That's my whole thing, right?
Yeah.
So did you go? It sounds like you went to the. It sounds like TJ took you to the places that were not here in Ocala.
Oh yeah.
You did not go to Olive Garden. You did not go to thing. Okay. Well, that was good.
We didn't. And he had a surprise for us. He wanted to make sure that he took my mother and I to this rooftop garden, which is one of the ones with the palm trees.
Do you remember the name of the?
It's a number like 236 or something like that.
Oh, yeah, it's the address probably.
Yeah, so that's the name. It's like 236 Rooftop Garden. And it was so great. I mean, you just go in there, and the first night we went, it was like date night, so you saw all the beautiful ladies in their short dresses and the fellas dressed up and everything. And it was just so beautiful looking out over the city, there. Oh, and my mother thought she saw a drone when we were on top of the Empire State Building.
She may have.
She was looking over the side, and she saw this green thing. It was sort of like hovering and then moving around and stuff. And then by the time I got my camera out, it was gone.
But oh, wow.
She said, look at that. I bet that's a drone.
It probably was. Yeah.
So that was, kind of scary, but it was way below us. So
how many miles do you think you put on your legs? How much did you walk?
Oh, wow. We probably walked 20 miles at least. Yeah, because up and down subway
stairs.
Hey,
Mom, for those who don't know, she's...
80 Yeah.
80. But she walks every day here in Ocala.
5 miles a day, yeah.
5 miles a day. So she was ready.
Oh, yeah.
How were you with the walking?
I was pretty ready, too. Yeah, I was pretty ready, and TJ and Charity were, you know, in front of us, and they were, you know, really booking it. So, well, we just kept up with them. We didn't want to get lost.
You gotta prepare.
But no, yeah. we were. It was great. It was wonderful. Nice time with my mom and my son and daughter-in-law, and they got a nice place in New Jersey and real wood floors. You know, very nice. They live on the bottom of a home that's shared by three families. It's a three-story, so they live on the ground floor.
I will not share with the audience the gift you brought me that I love. I mean, you brought us all something here, but until Galen's on the phone. I want to let Galen know what you got me. I think he'll get a kick out of it. And you got something for Galen, too, right?
Yes, I did.
Yeah. I won't say anything. It's a secret, a big secret.
But it was fun.
We were living vicariously through you, and now that you're talking about it, I guess it's fair to say I've never been a tourist in New York.
Mm-hmm.
When I moved down to Florida, I was a tourist, even though I lived here. I would go every place, and I felt like a tourist no matter where I went.
Yeah.
And actually, I learned to like being a tourist. You know how some people say, I don't want to be a tourist. I kind of like feeling like a tourist. So that sounds like fun. It sounds like something I would enjoy.
It was. And those buses are the best things ever, and the tour guides are fun. And one guy was wearing a fedora, and it was real windy one day, and his hat just blew off in the street. So
really?
Yeah. So the
driver's hat?
No, the guy, one of the passengers up top, so the tour guide that was up top, he was yelling at the driver to stop and get his hat, so he slammed the brakes on and stopped, and the guy went down and ran up the road.
Busy
and got
street?
The hat. Yeah, yeah. So that was pretty funny, and of course we always tipped them, because they were a lot of fun, and it was great.
Did you see the Book of Mormon?
No, but we priced it.
Yeah.
And that's another thing we learned, the difference between Broadway and off-Broadway and off-off-Broadway.
Okay.
We always thought it was the shows, but it's the number of seats in the house. Broadway shows
Know that either.
Broadway shows are 500 or more. Let's see. Off-Broadway are 300 to 499.
I never knew this.
Broadway is below that. We didn't either. We just thought it was a show because the tour guides, you know, specifically said, just because you're seeing something off Broadway doesn't mean it's not high quality. It's just the number of seats in the theater.
So how many seats at the Civic Theater here in Ocala?
I think it's 500.
So it's a Broadway production.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Exactly. The Lincoln Center was fabulous. We took a tour of that. Metropolitan Opera. Wow, that opera house is like what you see in the movies. And then they have a separate house for the ballet. That is what you see in the movies. Separate house for the symphony and a separate house for the theater. Theater has like 9 different stages on the stage. So they turn around. They're like elevators. They go underneath. They bring it up because they said in the Lincoln Center, you might have one show on a Monday and a Thursday, another show will be a Tuesday and a Wednesday, and you don't cut the sets down. So they put them on these elevator things, and that's how they keep them all intact. They just, you know, suck one set down and push the other one up.
Wow.
It is awesome.
Wow.
It is just so great to be a tourist. I just, you know, forgotten what it's like, what it's all about. It's great to be a tourist.
Yeah, you're getting us all excited, not just about your trip and about New York as a destination, but about doing that same thing in, you know,
here.
Who knows? Yeah, doing it here, doing it in Chicago, doing it anywhere, right?
Because like in, is it Orlando or Tampa? They have those horse-drawn carriages. And I mean, you know, that's like a touristy thing to do.
So if you got it right here.
There, you do, you do that. It was pretty cool. It was very, very nice. I forgotten what it was like, and I'm glad I went. Got to spend time with my mom and my son and daughter-in-law.
That is the best part.
That
right?
was the best part. Everybody was great. It was wonderful. Thank you so much.
Got somebody waiting patiently. I apologize for making you wait so long. Good morning. You're on the air.
Yeah. Good morning and welcome back, Robin.
Thank you, Hugh.
Say, the guys did pretty good while you were gone. And I said pretty good. I mean, they hung in there and they got their jobs done and we made it on time. I was wondering, did you get over to Yankee Stadium?
We went past it.
Oh, I wish you would have stopped for Galen because he's such a great Yankees fan. You could have picked up a pennant. That would have been a wonderful gift, a pennant for Garland from Yankee Stadium.
Oh, that would have been funny.
Oh, he'd have loved that. He must be in the seventh heaven right now because Boston beat Tampa. You know,
oh.
They're going to, they're moving on in the playoffs. But that Yankees pennant would have really did it for him today, you know.
Oh, wow.
That's kind of funny.
Okay, that we'll talk to you later.
But now, you said you saw is it Shea Stadium, or did they change the name to MetLife Stadium? What is the story with that?
Yeah, it's that big stadium there where
the Mets play.
Yeah, it says the name of the
MetLife Stadium.
Yeah, MetLife. No, okay. maybe I've gotten confused. Maybe it's the Giants Stadium that had MetLife. Anyway, there's this big stadium there, and it's got MetLife emblazoned on it. I mean, right. You cannot miss it. These letters are taller than
insurance,
buses.
Insurance,
you know?
Took over the world.
Exactly. Yeah. I know. I just didn't realize.
Well, you see it in every skyline. Yeah. Every skyline.
Yeah, but this is on the front of a stadium. It's like,
I know.
Oh my
well,
God.
That's the next thing.
Yeah, but it was a
naming
lot of
rights.
Fun.
It's a new thing, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's see. We will move forward now, and Galen will be on with us in just a little bit. So we'll take a little break and be right back. And by the way, I will reveal one of the souvenirs that Robin got me. She got me a New York City coffee cup.
Yeah.
Now, all these years, I've been drinking out of a Green Bay Packers coffee cup that you brought me from Milwaukee.
Yeah.
So now I'm torn. What do I drink my coffee out of?
You have to just have variety in your life. You can't have the same thing every day.
All right, we'll take a little break and we'll be right back. It is so good to have you back, Robin.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA.